Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we are going to see one of the premium per user feature, that is link tables from other data flows. This will not be available for pro users, and this is obviously it is for premium per capacity users as well. Let us try to check what is this feature. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for the notifications. We have seen the features that differentiate from pro users is paginated, advanced AI, data flows, and application. And this is the point we are going to see it today, that is data flows, direct query, link and computer, enhanced computer engine. What is this? Let us try to revamp the data flows. If you have not seen my data flows videos in the Power BI service playlist, just go and watch it. So basically, we will get the data from data sources and we will create some entities here and which can be consumed by multiple data sets, right? So that is the logic behind data flows, where we have explained in detail of when to use data flows, when to use that data flows in multiple data sets, those things. Just go and watch it. Now, one of the things is like you can see here, once you have your data flows defined after performing all the ETLs, then there might be some places where you can create another data flows, and that data flow should refer another entity, like link between other entities. So this is not available for the pro user. In order to have a link the entity, that is you have a data flow one and you are creating the data flow two. In the data flow two, you are referring another table from the data flow one. This is possible only if you have a premium user licensing, and the premium per user will give you this advantage. That is what we are going to see in this video. Let us jump into a demo. So I'm in Power BI services now. Already we have created one of the data flows here. You can see we have three data sets and one of the data flow over here. And what I'm going to do today is like, I do not have a premium capacity here, like the one over here, the premium workspace, right? Whereas I have another workspace and which is having premium capacity, it doesn't have any content. But we are not focusing anything on this. But how to create workspace where you need to have, once you have a premium per user license, whether you will get all the powers or what, it is not the case, right? We will see how to configure it. I already configured this user. I'm in trial period now. So once you go here and you have see here, like you will get access to a premium per user trial, right? I'm in trial period. Once you have a pro user, you can use that premium per user. You can enable it. Just clicking on it will give you the user license if you are a trial period, but you can buy it from the same way, or if your organization has admin who is capable of doing it, then he has to do it for you. Once you have a premium per user license, you just log in as a normal user, and as I mentioned before, now the thing is like, let us try to create the linked entity without having the premium workspace, right? This workspace is a normal pro user workspace, and we will try to see what happens when we create a linked entity in this workspace. Let us start. I'm going to create a data flows, and here when you define a new table, it is like creating a new workflow, that is data flow 2. Instead, I can choose this option, that is in the workflow 2, that is data flow, not a workflow, it's a data flow. I'm going to create a new data flow. In that, I'm going to link another data flow. So this is the case. I have already signed in. Just press next. Once you choose that option, that is linked data flow, it will list down what are the data flows available in your login or you have access to. So I have this data flow. In this, I'm going to choose this particular table, right? Then click on transform data. Now you can see here it is linked. That is, I'm going to create one data flow. In that, I am referring another table. Let us try to see it in a diagrammatic way. So this is the data flow that already exists. Okay, that is a sales table. Now I'm going to create this data flow, and here I'm referring this table over here. Okay, so this is my new data flow I'm trying to create. I'm referring this table. This can be any other table. Just you can consider this as a new entry. I want to create some table to store customer info or some product info. Okay, I'm not connecting any source here. Jeans and next is like shirt, something like that. Okay, that can be any data, and assume it can come from your SQL source or anywhere. Okay, I have this one. Now you can see here this linked entity. The warning says link tables cannot be modified, because you cannot modify here. In order to do any modification, you need to go to your source data flows, right? It is linked, just a link, you referring this table. So in any changes to this particular table, you have to do it in the data flow 1. Now I am in data flow 2, right? So data flow, and any changes made to the query will not be saved. Okay, any changes you do, that will not be saved at all. And one more thing is, like, linked table requires premium to refresh. Okay, basically to enable refresh, upgrade this workspace to premium capacity or remove this table. So you cannot save this data flow unless you make this workspace, the entire workspace, to be available as a premium capacity. That is the issue you will face, right? Let's try to cancel it now. I'm not creating now. Now, how to upgrade a workspace to a premium capacity? Now you have created this workspace. Now click on the settings, workspace settings. Now here, once you have created it, there is option here after creating a workspace, premium. So enable this workspace to the capacity, premium capacity, and you need to choose the premium capacity. It's a per user license. And if you have, I hope it is like when you have a purchased a premium per capacity, I hope it will list down that premium per capacity. Then default storage format, and it is not a very big, so I will choose a small format. Then that's it. This is these two settings you need to do. Then click on save. Now it's asking, like, only people have premium per user license will be able to access this workspace. So here is the check, like, you have one user having a pro user license, and you need to access this one, right? Premium per user workspace, he will not have access. That is what it says. So a premium per user workspace should be accessed by premium per user only. That is the thing. Now you can see the difference. Earlier there is not this icon is not up yet. This icon indicates it's a premium per user content. Now you go here and create your data flows that is referring another entity. There won't be any issues. This is the one of the important concept when you want to create a linked data flows. This feature is available only for the premium per user. Let's try to connect again. Click on the table. Now you can see that warning has disappeared, that it requires a premium to refresh those warnings, since it becomes a premium workspace and the premium per user can able to access it. So you can have assume the same thing. You have a product, and you can have that product information here, like jeans and shirt, and you can put some cost here. I mean, assume this is coming from different source, right? It can be 1000, bucks, and it can be a 1200, whatever. So now you have created the another data flow. You can save this one, you can create relationship, so your tables will be stored. Now we will go and see the data flows. Give the name here. This is something like product sales DF data flows. Just you can give anything. For our testing purpose, I gave whatever objects available here. You can rename this query as well, which is nothing but your data flows. Now you can go and see the different objects present in this data flow. Now you can have the two data flows here. One is sales, and one of the objects in the sales table is referred here. When you go and check it out, this is the link entity over here. And another important aspect of it, like we have mentioned here, like the direct query or computed entities. This is what linked or computed entities, and enhanced compute engine, right? So where that is available. So if you go to a data flow here and you do the settings, and there is option to choose switch it on or off. This option won't be available if you do not have a premium per user capacity. This options will be disabled, so you can set it to on. So your queries will be too much faster when it have more enhanced compute engine. So this is the future you will get. I hope you are clear about this particular point. We will try to explain the other features available for premium per user in our next upcoming videos. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.